and the boys like to shake, rattle, and troll.
It's time for the award-winning Shake, Rattle, and Troll.
Yeah, kids do what they like. Rack your favorite poems. Me and the boys gonna shake.
A show for the serious fishermen as well as the novice looking for tips from the pros. Shake, Rattle, and Troll, brought to you by Bill Luke Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. I-17 and Camelback Road since 1927.
Yeah, we got the power, we got the speed. We're running wide open on a midsummer breeze. Fresh water, salt water, watch out, boy. Fast Eddie Don's gonna make some noise. Me and the boys gonna shake, rattle, and
your host, saltwater fisherman, the man that fears no fish, Bass Daddy and tournament pro, Don McDowell.
Yeah, man. Hey, Don McDowell here. Welcome to the Sunday edition of Shake, Rattle, and Troll in the house. But this is JK, a.k.a. Special K.
Good morning, Bass Daddy. It was a fun night last night.
Really?
Yeah, just trying to get out of the car.
Advil, a little Bengay in the day, is there?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And back for the second week in a row, general manager from Bill Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram. May I throw Fiat in there?
Hey, you may throw it.
And Fiat.
It's one of the cars you can't throw.
Oh, boy, yeah. Yeah. And we have a special guest with us returning from this same time last year. Dwayne.
Almost exactly the same time. How are you?
You know, I look forward to this particular show more than anything that we do all year long.
Well, why is that?
It's just fun.
It's fun.
It's fun.
It's a little early for musicians, though. I was going to say, usually we don't see this time of day unless we're coming home from a party. Just
well,
just
my best guess is you just kind of stop by on the way home, right?
Exactly. No, yep, I had right a good, pretty good sleep last night. I didn't play last night, so we had the night off. So, yeah, I'm pretty refreshed.
And then as we go through the show, Larry the Lizard is here.
Larry,
hey, Larry.
Has
glummed on to.
Hey, how you doing, Larry the Lizard? Thanks, Don.
Yeah, good to have you here. Yeah, he's going to share some of his secrets with obtaining paychecks from Kim and Don Luke.
Take our money.
With the Lizard.
Where's the money?
Show me the money. $50,000 this year, guys. A couple things. One thing, John, I need to do before we get started. We're having the ACCA, the Arizona Catfish Conservation Association, is having catfish derbies. We mentioned on the show last week, now pay attention because I'm going to tell you this about 14 times a day so we get it. The catfish guys that are fishing on the west side or the county side of the lake are allowed by stipulation to transfer their fish properly out the park, down Highway 74, back into Pleasant Harbor for weigh-in. That only applies to catfish. If you're a bass fisherman, you can't do that. Follow the rules.
Yeah.
Bingo.
They're the one with the whiskers.
Yeah, right. Yeah. We have a problem with that. You know, last year, you know, we have the striper derby and striper options and you went over to Dwayne's camp, and he was having roast.
Oh, that was
striper.
Funny. That was so funny.
I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe I did that, too. And my son even told me, he says, Dad, let's get in the striper option, bass striper option. I said, no, son, there's a lot of great fishermen here. There's no way. There's no way we're even going to compete with them. When I get back to camp, I'm eating this nice striper that we've caught. Kim walks up and says, what is that? I said, taste it. And he goes, oh, yeah, it's really good fish. What is it? And I said, striped bass. And he goes, you didn't weigh that fish today? And I said, no. I didn't figure that I'd be even competing. He goes, nobody weighed a fish today. That's a $1,000 fish you just eat right there.
$1,000 fish
it,
dinner.
Yeah. Had me on the back. My son goes, I told you, Dad.
Boy, that was
I'm not going to tell any of my secrets because I'm getting into this. I'm getting every option.
Yeah,
possible.
That turned out to be $100 a bite.
Oh, nice. Boy, I couldn't stomach it after that. I just gave it away.
Are you going to be fishing this year?
Negative on that, Ghost Rider. Nope. Too many beer sales. Somebody's got to man the booth.
Well, you know, at an archery event, I would think you would be there. Yeah, we have Arizona Bull Fishing out there slugging the carp and they're having their own little derby. I need to take this chair down to the dealership and get some shocks on it.
Oh, come on. There's a little chair.
I got a Fiat chair.
Thanks.
All right. You know, Kim, I'm excited. We put our order in for some nice days. It looks like the weather report is really solid.
It's amazing.
Yes, it is. Sunny, 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 and sunny.
Bingo.
All in the 80s.
That should be just like we're having today.
Yep, exactly.
You know, I watched the sun come up and going, yeah, this is a good thing. It's all good. Anyway.
Should make the fishing real good.
Oh, yeah. I'm telling you, the fishing's on fire everywhere. I stopped by the tackle box yesterday on the way back from Roosevelt, and Roosevelt's blown up, Bartlett's blown up, Pleasant's blown up, and Pleasant's a difficult lake. If you're not on fish, you're going to suffer.
Yeah.
And a lot of different patterns going on right now. Fish are in pre-spawn. Some of the bucks are locking on. Some of the big girls are trying to lock on. So,
you know, one thing we haven't mentioned throughout this about where to fish and stuff like that, basically we should get across that the marina is off limits.
Yes.
Pleasant Harbor Marina is off limits. So make sure you don't get been behind there and catch some fish, because if you caught a big one back there, you may make...
That's anywhere from all the tires, the brake
wire, right.
Right. All the way back into there.
Yeah, all the way back in that
big
cove.
Fish in there, but you can't be fishing,
in there.
Wait a minute, what about shore fishermen?
Well,
That's a
good question.
That's a good question.
Yeah.
I guess we'll have to figure that out between now and then.
If nobody can go in the marina, I may participate if I can go offshore.
Yeah. And you know, there's no fishing in the marina, and I would suspect that also means no fishermen on the bank.
Huh. Interesting. Because it's a very easy access from that.
Right, the question on the lie detector test is did you fish in the marina?
Ah, well, guess what? There's no fishing in the marina then, right?
Bingo.
I guess that settles that one.
Go ahead, go, Larry. And I can tell you, 2 years ago, I had to fish from the bank, and I didn't have to fish in the marina to get a couple paychecks.
Well, you got three or four paychecks.
No, not last year, the year before.
Okay, whatever. Every time I turn around, he's up there going, yeah.
That's Larry. That's not me. I didn't
right.
get paid anything.
Well,
I just eat my fish.
You know, there's another marina.
Yeah.
I mean,
Scorpion Bay.
Yeah, and there's another marina just north on the north ramp. So,
yeah.
It's not a marina, but I mean, it's a cove. You can get right to and walk right down to, and
quite frankly, that's a real good spot.
And you can walk around that whole mountain to the left, so you're very good.
And the snakes are out.
Yeah, be careful.
Especially at the wood pile where they go to get firewood.
Yeah, I tend to stay away from there.
They're snakes. All right, what else have we got going on, Kim?
Well, we've gone over this stuff a lot of times, and all I can tell you that is every camping spot is done. We have no more left.
Everything is sold out.
Everything's sold out. All the vendor spots are sold out, and you can't bring beer inside the fence this year because we have a beer garden this year. So we have to keep the beer on the outside. And you can go to the beer garden and get your beer there. Be sure before you go up to the bar itself and get one of the guys to serve you a beer that you get a wristband check, because you will not be served without a wristband.
Unilateral. So at 60 some odd years old, I have to go get an ID check.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Good stuff. And what beers are we having, JK?
We're going to have Coors, Coors Light, Miller Light. We're going to have Keystone and Blue Moon, I think, and Red Apple Ale.
That ought to do it.
That'll be enough.
If you can't find one out of that, forget about
it. Beer, that's good, man. It sounds good to me.
That sounds like a song I know.
That's right.
Wish
exactly
I had
right
a beer.
Yeah.
Nice gold beer.
Oh, we're going to do that song,
okay,
too. Yes.
I've been practicing all year.
I see that you brought your tambourine. Somebody did.
Oh,
this is Kim's.
It's mine.
Did you bring your triangle?
Triangle.
Yeah.
No. Ding, 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 ding.
Yeah,
no, I didn't bring any of that.
Lead triangle player.
Go get some spoons out of my hunting backpacks in the truck.
Yeah, just put your finger between them.
That's funny. We got to write a jingle for Larry here. Larry the Lizard. Let's get a jingle going. Let's write a song about Larry the Lizard.
Wish I had a lizard. Great big lizard.
Larry was a lizard.
Got these guys.
Gotta smell like garlic.
It Italian.
Italian garlic, huh? I see it.
My question is, are we going to have a radio show come Monday morning?
We are not going to have a radio show come Monday morning.
Woo! All right, that's all good. All right, let's hit the highlights, and we'll fill in the blanks. Registration starts 4 o'clock at the registration tent at the lake at the Grassy Knoll on Thursday at 4 p.m. Fishing starts promptly at 6 o'clock Friday, Saturday, and Sunday for the largemouth, and we'll fill in the blanks on the catfish guys and the carp shooters are kind of like in their own time zone. Daily weigh-ins, we've got 6 hourly weigh-ins paying $300 for first place, $100 second through 10th place, and the stage opens up between 4 and 4:30 for awards daily. We have a boat show, the first annual boat show. Dwayne, you want to sell your boat?
I've already sold it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I've already sold it. It's done.
Okay, you can buy a boat.
The Southwest's largest family fishing tournament and festival pre-owned boat sale. Feature your boat for 3 days and be seen by over 10,000 visitors for only $25. So you pay $25, you get your 20 by 20 foot spot, right? Security on site, yeah. 4 concert tickets to my concert.
Mm-hmm, your concert.
Oh, I like that.
You're kind of expensive. I gotta do something.
I guess so. But all this for $25, you could actually sell your boat. I have already sold
my
boat.
Teacher
okay,
would
while, need a while boat. Dwayne I need a boat, is going though. On with that, we're going to thank some of our other sponsors, and we'll be back more with the reading from Dwayne.
I love you too, Dwayne.
That worked good. I liked it.
Everyone drink. It's not as bad as we used to think. With every Manhattan, your stomach will flatten. So drink, drink. Got around, got
in. Good. Right, bring it back, buddy. We're back.
We're back. We're live. We're here.
All righty. Before we get carried away here, a couple other things. We've got Dina Preston Band playing on Friday night. Dwayne is going to just rock the house on Saturday night. Cornhole tournaments. Car shows. We've got the Mopar Car Club, Arizona Viper Club, all makes models. Jeeps, and we're even let the Toyota Rock Crawlers, what do they call those things? FJs? FJs, okay. Red Rock Helicopters offering helicopter rides in a Bell Jet Ranger. We have a full-fledged free carnival with rides for the kids. A lot of stuff going on out there. We have Piglies at the Fair for the main table fair with all kinds of collateral. I'm going to call it carnival food. Wouldn't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, cotton candy and kettle corn and snow cones.
Cool. The usual suspects.
The one thing that scares me is Italian shaved ice. I never know what them guys are up to.
No. There'd be garlic in it.
Oh, yeah. A little marinara sauce. Yeah. Good stuff. And then I think one of the big headliners we have is the 1943 M18 Hellcat Army tank destroyer.
That is going to be awesome. I've always seen pictures of it.
It's fully functional.
Really?
It'll run 60 miles an hour.
Oh.
It's got a 76 millimeter cannon.
Can I ride in it?
With the firing pin, a 30 caliber and a 50 caliber.
Wow.
Yeah, buddy. And Kim's task for the whole weekend is to pull the trigger on the tank promptly on Saturday at 1600 hours.
Really?
Yeah.
Is fire live?
I suggest it.
He kind of aimed at the stage. When you shoot the.
Back up.
We'll see how this works. You shoot the air cannon.
Okay.
With a t-shirt in it.
With a t-shirt in it.
And I'll lob you.
Hey, wait. I got it.
There was a stage, right?
We can just pack the barrel with t-shirts.
Oh, there you go. Boom.
They're going to pick them out of the Agua Fria north.
And shoot them to New River. Sure, with Scorpion Bay.
Yeah, I was going to say you got to go to Scorpion Bay to pick them up.
Nice. All right, anything else we need to highlight, Kim? There's so much. We've got a full-fledged vendor tent. Something for everybody. We've got some really cool stuff coming out from Charles in the Mopar tent. Shirts, hats. barbecue sauce.
Yeah, we've gone overboard with all the stuff overboard. This year.
We can't keep it in stock.
I know. That's funny. We get it ordered, and it comes in last week, and it's selling faster than we can get it out to the lake.
Yeah, it's all good. All right, Dwayne.
What I do, I did this song last year, and I haven't recorded it yet, but you guys need to help me. So we have a tambourine. What else we got? We got one more tambourine. I thought you were going to bring your triangle. Okay, there it is. All right, so sail away, guys. That's all we have to do.
Sail away.
Get your voices ready. All right, let's practice.
You do this
Everybody
so
sing
well.
Sail away. Ready? One, two, three, go.
Sail away.
Oh, okay, that is awesome. Sound like a choir. Wish I had a boat, a pirate boat, with a little bell and a big sail and a captain's hat. Imagine that. We'll sail away. Come on.
Sail away.
Good. Wish I had beer, ice cold beer. The Mexican guy with salt and lime. In my boat, we'll make a toast, then sail away.
Sail away.
Yeah. Walking on this beach in this paradise, I've never felt so high in
trouble.
I saw something shiny sticking out of the sand. Now I'll give it a rub and see what comes to me. Wish I had a girl, an island girl, who likes my boat, likes me the most. With the moon above, we'll fall in love, then sail away. Come on.
Sail away.
Good. There's not much I wish for, standing by the waves. A few things in life I'll ever need. I know it's in this oil lamp I found on the beach. A breath and tell me one, two, three. Wish I had a boat, a pirate boat, with a little bell and a big sail and a captain's hat. Imagine that, and we'll sail away. Come on,
sail away.
Yeah. Wish I had beer.
Beer.
Ice cold beer.
Yeah. Beer.
The Mexican kind.
Beer.
Salt and lime.
Beer.
In my boat. Gotta hope it floats. We'll sail away. Come on.
Sail away.
Wish I had a girl. An island girl. Who likes my boat. And likes me the most. With the moon above. We'll fall in love. And sail away, come on.
Sail away.
With the moon above, we'll fall in love. Then sail away.
Sail away.
Guys, let's take this thing on the road.
All right, you got to do another cut.
We're getting the band back together. You guys are going to do this with me, all right?
Kim, you're in the band.
You're in the band.
We sang that last year,
Don. That was great. Wow. Great work right there.
What else have you got in store?
Oh, I don't know. We just I got a couple of other ones I haven't finished yet, but did my Mossback song. That was kind of fun.
Yeah.
You remember that one? Mossback. That Mossback is about a big fish. It's, you guys saw
biggest fish in the world.
Tell us about it.
Early in the morning down around the bend by the bridge on the river, fishing pole in hand. Mossback, I'm here again today. Somehow Mossback, he always gets away. Break my line, break my pole. Mossback waiting in my fishing hole. Bet your boots, you can bet your life, I'll catch that fish before I die. Before I die. Pretty cool, huh?
Oh, yeah. Get her done.
A long time now, he's been waiting in the river for as long as I remember underneath that log. Mossback, I'm here again today. Somehow Mossback, he always gets away. Break my line, break my pole. Mossback waiting in my fishing hole. Bet your boots, you can bet your life, I'll catch that fish before I die. Before I die.
Outstanding.
Yeah, man. Yeah. And you know what? That's going to be my $1,000 fish. I'm going to get a paycheck on Friday and Saturday.
There you go.
I just know it.
I'd personally like to give it to you.
You know, I'm going to use this. Can I have this?
Absolutely.
Larry the Lizard has got some bait going here.
All right. Yeah,
don't
come
put
back,
that in your wallet.
Oh, no.
We'll hear about the lizards, and we're going to thank some of our sponsors. Jennifer, get us out of here. All right, we're back. Here we go. I don't know where we're going, but we are on the way. Back to you, Dwayne.
Well, I just come up with this song. I took this girl to Mexico one time, and she had this little bell, and she'd ring it. We went to by the beach and sit in there and got all, you know, kickback. She goes, watch this. She'd ring this little bell, and this cabana boy guy would come out and give her drinks, like, you know, serve her drinks, little dirty free drinks. I'm watching this guy running back and forth, and I'm thinking to myself, man, I could be that guy. So yeah. I thought, you know what, I'm going to write a song about this. So she had this little bell. So imagine a bell, you just ring it, and then the cabana boy guy would come out. So she called him her boy toy.
Ooh.
Yeah, so you guys have to go boy toy, all right? Now we're getting the female vocals to go, oh, cabana boy, all sexy like that, okay?
This is all consistent with our family values.
That's exactly yes. Right. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Boy toy.
Oh, cabana boy.
Yeah, there it is. Boy toy.
Oh, cabana boy.
Boy toy.
Oh, cabana boy.
Boy toy.
Oh, cabana boy.
Hello, my name is Chico from down in Mexico. I make my living on the beach. Es bonitas mujeres. Lord, I swear it's the only life for me. Oh, when you come down to see me, I swear you will believe me. I'll make your every dream come true. Just ring your bell for Cabana Boy, and I will take care of you.
Oh, Cabana Boy.
Yeah, here we go. You ready, guys?
Boy toy.
Oh, Cabana Boy.
There she is.
Boy toy.
Oh, Cabana Boy.
Boy toy.
Oh, Cabana
Boy. Don't you see my
boy.
This is
about she's perfect. Really good.
Let's give her a female vocal.
Yeah. Yeah.
The lady behind the window.
That was perfect.
Jennifer, you're in the band.
You're in the band, Jennifer. We're going to take this thing on the road. Jennifer and the boys, that's what we're going to call our band. What do you think?
All right,
anyway, you get my gist. I don't want to repeat. That song is going to get done. That's going to be on a brand new album that I am personally putting out this year.
Cool. When's it coming out?
Well, hopefully by September, but we're working on it right
you
now.
You come down, we'll have a debut right
we
here.
We will have a debut, and I would love to sing the whole album right here if I can do the show.
Done.
It'll be fun.
Yes, fact.
Wait a minute. Where's the arm twisting you need?
We're out of here.
Okay. Right, you can bring the beer.
Point.
See?
Okay.
Blue Moon.
Blue Moon.
Yeah. Goes with it. The boy toy and Blue Moon.
Boy toy.
That's some scary stuff.
Oh, it is scary. We're
not going to be in business anymore.
Where's Don Luke today?
Dear
hopefully
Don.
Asleep.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I hope he is too. This is well.
He was here last week.
Don was?
Yeah.
He was here last year too, but at the same time I was here. It was awesome. He had the six gun and the thing. It was awesome.
Kim and I were going over the prize package. And every once in a while we'd get to one and he'd go, "We are.
We are."
There was this deer in the headlight look going, oh boy. Yeah, Kim just wants to brush over and move on.
Can you just keep moving, Don?
Yeah, a couple times, you know, Kim's a good guy, you know, and he goes, we're getting into the money thing, and, you know, I'm trying to get the prize package out, and Kim's going, Don, how's your fly fishing? Trying to divert.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, you missed out on the monkey story. That was a riot.
I had more phone calls over that. Don Luke getting in a kicking contest with an orangutan wanting these biscuits.
Oh, my gosh.
I was the first time he ever told that story to me, he was telling me what was happening. And I was keeping a straight face because I couldn't, you know, he was leading up to it. It's the first time I'd ever heard it, right? And, gosh, he got to that part about the monkey jumping up and grabbing the saucer. And having a saucer out in the middle of Africa. You got to think about that.
Well, so, we have. You know, there's been discussion. Everybody sitting here would be drinking from an old mug.
Canteen.
Whatever.
Well, you know.
What
can I tell you?
I'm just saying.
If you own a car dealership, maybe you can do that.
You get to have a saucer.
Yeah, rough it. Yeah. With this saucer and biscuit.
All right. Let's get back to the financial aspect of this 16th annual endeavor. The big bass option, Dwayne.
Yes, sir. I
pays $1,000.
My experience, for the experience big alone, I am going to enter, and I strongly suggest everybody enter the options, the options,
now,
because you never know.
There's
never
a t-shirt know. Option.
Now, tell me about that, because I don't
know. The t-shirt option pays $1,000 for whomever weighs the seventh largest bass, so you don't have to catch the big one.
Oh, interesting.
Between the 11 and 12 weigh-in. But you have to have the Bill Luke t-shirt.
Got a question. What if nobody weighs in but you?
I'm going to respond by saying, fat chance, John.
Why the seventh? The seventh.
Just son. Because.
Just
because.
Chose it. That's cool. That
just
really
because
cool.
We can.
So
because when you get to the scales, you don't know who. Well, we've got the phone card app. So you can swipe it across your phone. You know who's ahead of you, but you don't know who's behind you.
Ah.
There might be a guy sitting back there with the 10 or a 12.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah. Okay, that's cool.
Yeah.
So, in essence, if you were to do this early entry fees, it's only $60 for early.
Right.
And 70 day of the show, which isn't bad.
Right. Kids fish for free under 14.
Under 14. So, basically just for somebody like me, because I never enter until the day of. 70 and then another 20 for the big bass option per day, and it's another 25 for the striped bass, and then it's 25 for the t-shirt, right?
Right.
So that's awesome.
And you can win.
And you can win buku bucks.
Buku bucks. You can definitely get your money back.
We're handing out for the big bass. We're going to hand somebody a check for $10,000.
Wow.
Of fish.
Wait a minute. What about the sign-in books?
Wow.
Sign-in books. You got to sign in for the. There's two options, or not options, there's two payouts. Bonus cashes that you can win. And that's, what is it, Friday and Saturday?
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Sunday, $1,000.
Well, that's where Don went sideways.
Yeah, he
kind of
did.
Imagine that. Anyway, everybody going sideways in this question. Yeah.
But to win those, what you have to do is you have to go down to the Sportsman and sign in. Sportsman's Warehouse, and you have to go to Bill Luke Chrysler Jeep and Dodge, a Camelback and I-17.
Don't forget Ram.
And Ram. And Fiat.
Yeah. Okay.
Boy, that left us all breathless.
Yeah, I'm going. It's taken 5 years
to get speak up.
Yeah. It's taken 5 years to get away from saying big bass days.
I know.
Yeah, I still say that, and I've been trying to catch myself. It's just bass days. It's
bass days.
And I was the one that switched that. Even Don asked me why I did that.
Yeah, thanks, Kim. By the way, why did you do that?
I really don't know.
Oh, okay. All righty. You know, got a $500 million a year dealership, and he doesn't know.
Just to confuse the rest of us and keep us on
It's confused me ever since as well.
All right, we're getting it. Dwayne, here's the deal. If you don't want to consume your striper,
okay,
or eat the carp,
that's another option. You know, I got a really good carp recipe, but go ahead.
Well, yeah. Well, we're donating all of the mortalities from because stripers don't do well in a live well.
They don't. They're not the hardy fish at all.
The carp don't do well when you slug them with a broadhead.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Muzzy will do that to you. Yeah.
So, all of those fish are going over to Adobe Mountain to offset their food budget for feeding the rehab animals.
I saw that, and I think that is awesome. As I remember, I did get into the striped option last year on Saturday, and we weighed, but there was somebody else that beat us out. But we weren't able to keep our fish at that point. But most of them were, they don't do live. They don't do well in the live well. They do die before they even get there most of the time. So, yeah. And that's good, though, that at least they're getting, you know, to sort of a charity type of situation here and going to feed what now? Animals?
Rehab animals. John, what's their food budget for the year?
Their total budget to run that refuge is $35,000
a year.
Yeah.
Wow. That's big.
So those fish mean a lot of money to him.
Sure. It does.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wow.
All righty, we're going to stand down. Thanks some of our sponsors. When we come back, we do not have to do roll call. We don't have any killed in action soldiers in theater this week. Quite a number of WIAs. But anyway, we're going to thank our sponsors and thank goodness we don't have any roll call this week.
And dropped it in the water in a shady nook. The bobber jumped when Mr. Whiskers hit. My gal flipped and throwed a fit. She pulled and tugged and yelled, "What's wrong?" I said, "Baby, he's a big and that cat's real gone."
Catfish, boogie, 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 boogie. Catfish, boogie, 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 boogie.
Catfish, boogie, do it, baby, with me. Eyes did roll. She said, "Set your pole and let's take a stroll." We walked along the creek, me and my miss. She gave me a hug and a great big kiss. She held me close and said, "I love you." I said, "I got all of this and fishing too."
Catfish, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie. Catfish, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie.
Catfish, boogie, do it, baby, with me.
Surely you can't be serious. I am serious. Now don't call me Shirley.
All right, here we go. We are back. Kim Andrews is in the house.
Kim Andrews, hey!
Is he going to sing that stuff actually on the air?
No.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
You sure?
Yeah, this is the Kim and Dwayne
show. I'm looking
show.
For a new gig. So.
Fuck you, my dog.
Turns out. Hey, today we are doing the man code, you know, to keep that man card in your wallet and out of her purse. Today we're dealing with a very important subject, public restrooms, and how you deal with that as a real man. There are three rules for you to deal with. No introductions at the urinal. Definitely no eye contact. And the third and most important rule, if you jiggle it more than twice, you're actually playing with it. So don't do it. Keep the man card safe. And as always, keep it real, man.
Well, I've got some of the greatest advice I've heard. I definitely don't want
Kim,
any.
Kim, are you going to be okay?
Wow. Oh, my God.
Uh-oh.
Another problem in public restrooms is the earpieces that we wear with the mobile phones. I mean, you're standing there, and you don't know the other guy, what he's doing. He's talking on the phone. You're standing there, and he goes, "Well, how about dinner tonight?"
Pardon?
Oh, I gotta go.
Yeah, no shaking involved at that point.
Yeah.
All right, so do we have man cards at Bass Days?
We need man cards.
Are they? They're at the printer, right?
Negative on that, Ghost Rider.
No, they will be after the show.
Excellent timing, Patrick. Another job well done, sir. Let's give a big hand to Patrick.
Way to go, Pat.
By the way, I just want to let everybody know that I will be taking the prize for the largest flathead catfish at the...
I thought it was the largest flathead Ed t-shirt.
Okay. So I've gained a few pounds. But I
life
tell
is
you,
good.
I'm living with an Italian, and she can cook. It's pretty awesome.
I love it.
Man, can she cook.
Wow.
Pretty good in the kitchen, too.
Kind of smells like Larry's lizard.
Like Larry's lizard right here. Got a little garlic flavor, too.
Yeah, it's a little small, actually. But
all right, so what's the plan with you and Flathead?
Well, Flathead Ed's going to point me in the right direction, and, you know, we're going to make sure that we bring in the biggest flathead catfish.
And we're suggesting that this fish is going to be between 50 and 60 pounds?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. That's the plan. And, you know, if nothing else, I'll be chilling in the redneck camouflage rocker recliner,
Dwayne,
on the boat.
It's
the only way to fish.
You have no idea.
Tell
Dwayne about the boat.
I want to hear this. Yeah, please do tell me.
There's
about
a song
boat.
In this.
As soon as I went earlier this year, or last year, I guess it was, with Flathead Ed, and as soon as I walked up to the dock, and I see this 24-foot pontoon pull up, and the first thing I see is a completely camouflaged rocker recliner. He said, I am home.
Goodbye, honey.
Sell the house.
Holy cow. Will this somebody will adopt my kids? Will it be on the lake?
Yes, with me on it.
I can't wait to see this.
Yeah, it's a blast.
Do you really fish from this recliner?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Why flathead fishing ain't like bass fishing?
No.
No, you get to sleep.
You get to sleep.
But if you get any if you get any 4 or 5 pound carp, so that's the bait fish.
Here's a picture of it right here. Get out. All the rods are just sitting there. I got a beverage in your hand. This is wonderful.
Yes.
This is
non-alcoholic reclining. Beverage, of course.
Of course. No, we can't drink it. But that is awesome. Yeah. That is awesome right there.
And if you ain't catching fish, you are catching nothing but flathead head telling you pretty much every joke that was ever written.
Oh, that's funny.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, in character. So look out. I'll be ready for my check on Sunday. So
there's a man right there.
Can't wait. And, Kim, I'm glad you're not nearly as red now as you were just a couple minutes ago. Dwayne is always going to be awesome with Mogion on stage, man. I can't wait for it. So.
That's going to be a lot of fun. Holy cow, there's a big old fish. I'm looking at a big old flathead right here.
Oh, how
big is this fish?
Was that the 70? That's whose?
That was yours.
Oh, no, actually, that was my son's. That was Big Jake's fish. It started out about 9 pounds, and by the time we got to the dock, I think 14, wasn't it?
14 pounds. 14 pounds? Sure. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
3 years later.
You know, unrelated to the tournament this year, I lived over in Dobson Ranch and one of the lakes over there, was just later unknown, but my son, this is interesting about flatheads. This is my experience with them. I had a deep sea rod, and we lived on the lake. And my son, you know, going up there on the lake, teaching him to fish, and we would catch these little bluegill. And I'd hook them through the dorsal and cast them out, and we stick the rod in the middle of the umbrella sleeve of a table. And then I took my kids and my wife to dinner. I come back and I get the kids all into bed. My son, I think, was 7 at the time. Get them all into bed and shut the light off. And all of a sudden, I hear this, "Dad, we forgot to check the fishing pole." And I said, "Son, we'll do it in the morning. It's too late." He goes, "No, Dad, I got a feeling." So on goes the light, gets his pajamas and his little slippers. We go back outside. We flip the back porch light on, and there's the rod, and it's bent over. Boring. I said, "Grab that thing and jerk up on it." He goes, "Dad, I think it's stuck." And he's throwing it. And I hold the rod from him, and I feel this great big old fish moving. And I said, "Son, you got something gigantic. Let me go get your mom and your sister out of bed." And a little sister was 4 at the time. So I went and got the mom and the tailor out of bed. And we come back downstairs, and he is horsing. He goes, "Dad, I don't want to lose him. He's gigantic." I see this big old fish come from the water. I literally had to reach down with both hands to pull this fish out. And when I pulled out this fish, 47 pounds flathead.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
I'm moving.
Pounds.
That's ginormous.
I mean, I got even, the way I pissed, because I told my then wife, I said, "Hey, go get the scale out of the bathroom," and I weighed myself, and then I picked up the fish and weighed it. 47 pounds dead.
Oh, no. John.
Now, having said that, real quick, and I hope
that is the most politically correct term I have ever
What's
heard.
What's that?
My then wife.
My then wife.
That was at the beginning of the story, and you remember it now.
Yeah, that's all he's been thinking about
all the whole time.
But I told my then wife, I said, "Look, you know, I think that there's a 50-plus pounder in here. There's got to be a 55 pounder in here." So I did the same thing 2 weeks later. I got a little bluegill, put it out there, and this time I let it sit overnight. The next morning, I get up, the rod's bent over, I take a big jerk on it, I holler up at her, she's showering and getting ready for work, and I up in a double, you know, two-story house, and I whistle at her, I said, "I want you to witness this." As I'm pulling in this fish, that big old fish, his head came out of the water and shook his head and spit out an 18-inch channel cat that had my bait inside of it.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, that is no lie. That is a 60-pound flathead. That's my story on flathead.
Was it just the thought of your then, or the sight of your then wife?
No, exactly. She saw her just. She's like,
"No!
That's all you, dude. I don't want any part."
So much for political correctness.
Oh, yeah, exactly. So, anyway, I can't wait to see you. Nice, man.
All right. Thanks, man. We will catch you out there next weekend. Cannot wait.
You're the man. I'll tell you what, Tim Andrews, we're looking forward to seeing
you. Tim Andrews is a flathead man.
Love All it. Right. Dwayne,
yes,
close us out, man.
I don't know what. Should we do a Johnny Cash song?
Yes.
Everybody?
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, guys, I need some help. I hear that train coming.
Boy, toy.
It's rolling down the rain. ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when I'm stuck in Folsom prison. And time keeps dragging on. Good job, guys. Well, I hear that lonesome whistle on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me so. Always be a good boy, don't you ever play with guns. Well, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. Yeah, with some tambourines, guys, come on. Well, I hear that lonesome whistle,
I hit my head and cry.
Well, they freed me from this prison, and that railroad train was mine. I bet I'm moving on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I long to stay.
Go!
Hey. Woo! And I'd have that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
Now, here's your host, saltwater fisherman, the man that fears no fish, Bass Daddy and tournament pro, Don McDowell.
Yeah, man, we're back. I want to thank Dwayne Moore for coming down from Mogollon. Woohoo! Man, that guy is one awesome entertainer. In with us now, Larry the Lizard. Larry, thanks for coming down, man. You got some new baits. What have you been working on?
Well, first, Don, thanks for having me.
My pleasure, buddy.
I have been working on the Pro Tour Rattling Worm is the bait that we're bringing out this year.
Not to be confused with your Rattling Lizard.
Correct.
Okay.
Right, not to be confused with that big old 10-inch Rattling Lizard. And I'm pretty excited about these. I've been drop-shotting these and Texas rigging them, and I've been doing really good on these lakes. Apache was on fire with them. Bartlett, I caught a nice sack of fish on them. They've been doing good at Pleasant as well. I can't wait to get them down to some of the other lakes like Saguaro and Canyon and these great lakes we have out here like Roosevelt too.
I'm not seeing this for the first time. This is probably the second time, but the first time I saw this, upper body seems, with the water dispersion rings on, it seems to be hollow.
Well, there is a little tiny hollow strip in there. And what that does is it allows that worm to act like not just a power worm, but a trick worm as well. And that gives it a little extra flotation.
Okay, John just had an eyebrow come up.
Yeah.
Talk to me, Goose.
Trick worm. Tell him what a trick worm does.
Okay, a trick worm, when you're jigging it, shaky head, it's going to do a lot of different things in the water. It's going to be reacting somewhat like a live nightcrawler would be jiggling around.
Squirming around
with like a wacky motion to it.
That's a good term.
Squirming. But squirming. Is the best way to describe it, yeah. So these are a lot like a power worm in the sense that you can fish them just like a power worm, but they have all the ability of a trick worm. Then you have the rattling chamber in the tail as well, and that's a curly tail with that flange or hinge on it. You've got a constant distress signal going out in the water. You've got a power worm, a swim bait, and a trick worm all in one worm. So you've got a great diversity of how you can actually fish these things, what kind of cover, how deep. I mean, the techniques you're using, drop-shotting, Texas rig, would be the two that I'm thinking of right now, especially for this time of the year.
Okay, you gotta satisfy a curiosity here because I'm tempted because I shook it and it rattled.
Don't bite it.
I just want to tear it open and see how it's done. How you do that?
It's a tiny secret. I tell you, I have to kill
no,
you.
No, don't go there. No. When he said squirming, I kept thinking of my sister.
No.
She always used to do that whenever I'd beat her up.
Oh, that was a long time ago, but that's all right.
Man.
Behave.
Okay.
Eat your bagel. We'll get back. No, seriously. How do you put that in?
Actually, yeah. That is a trade secret.
Okay. Way cool. I just want to rip it open. You know that. I'm not going to, because this one's going
ahead.
With me.
You want to see what's in there? It's a 4-millimeter glass rattle. This is all American product, so this is the highest quality you can get. Those glass rattles you go into Bass Pro and buy them are about $4.50 plus tax for 10 of them. So these are the high quality glass rattles. in the American floating soft plastic.
How many beads are in
garlic,
there?
There's two. Okay. So you're not getting an overwhelming vibration, but you're getting just enough that says, hey.
I'm here.
I'm here, and something's wrong with me.
Big boy, come here. Hurt, 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 eat me.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk a little bit about the lizards. Are you going to have a selection of lizards out at Bass Days?
Well, you know what I've decided is I want to have some out there, so we're going to have some out there, but we want the kids to be fishing. So what we're going to do is we're going to donate baits to be out there, and then if you give a donation for the kids' bass fishing club, then we'll just give you a bag of the baits. And that way the kids benefit from it, and, you know, they'll be available there.
Can you define kid?
Yes.
You know where I'm going with this.
14 years and under.
Well, really, I'll tell you, for me, fishing was a big part of my life growing up, and it's a passion that I've had, and it's saved me from being in probably a lot of trouble instead of some trouble in my life. Yeah. So, you know, I want to see the kids get out there and get to be out on the water and experience life in a way that our society just isn't letting them experience. And that's one of the only ways, is get them out there in nature. Let them see what the lake's all about. Let them see what we're supposed to be out there doing.
That takes us right back to the Luke family values that Don Luke, Kim, myself, we're trying to reestablish that, and I'm really glad you brought that up. We have the Arizona Bass Nation. Goodyear Bass Club will be there teaching kids to cast. The Bass Federation of Arizona from FLW will be there. John Sneed will be there doing some fizzing seminars, which are good.
When is that? Because I want to go. I've never had to fizz a fish in my whole life. I've never fished deeper than 20 feet of water, ever.
John's going to be doing those, a couple of them on Friday. I don't know what the exact times are, but it's going to be after the guys are off the water. And this kind of stems from an episode they had at one of the lakes. They had 11 mortalities, and the fish were dead when they came to the scales. And the fish needed to be fizzed, and the guys were fizzing them either incorrectly. You know, I've done it myself. You try to fizz a fish the first time, you go, okay, I got this needle. All right, hold still. And you let too much air out of the air bladder. That fish is over. He's done. He's going to the bottom, and he's not coming up again. So talking with Chief Cantrell and John Sneed, John really does an outstanding job with his fish protocol, keeping bass alive. He's got his bunk tanks, holding tanks. And I was talking to T.J. Stalling from TTI Blakemore. Ron's coming out from Alabama. Sure Life Laboratories is sending some of their research, and Kim, it kills zebra and quagga mussel larvae and largemouth bass virus. Wow. That's just a side product. Actually, what it does... John, I don't know if you put some of this in your iced tea, if it'll calm you down, but it's a calming agent for the fish. It's got an antibacterial solution in it because, you know, this bass has already been stuck, so he's wounded, okay?
Yeah.
Got an open wound. Slime has been removed over a large portion of the body. If he comes in, you get a thumb in the face, you get put on a scale, you get thrown in the live well. You get a marker buoy in your mouth, and then the process is reversed. So, I mean, this, you know, and you get to go for a boat ride.
Long boat ride.
Yeah, depending on if you got caught first thing in the morning, you got a boat ride till 2:30 in the afternoon. So this sedative really helps promote fish health. And the antibacterial stuff is kind of, I don't know, it's penicillin for fish or whatever it is. So
now, what's the name of this again?
Sure Life is the name of the parent company, but Release Me. Please release me.
Yeah. Okay, the same one I've had for a long
good
time.
Good stuff. Yeah, we're going to be putting that out there for Sure Life. We're going to get in behind them and promote it. Anything we can do to keep fish alive is the right thing to do. But going back down to the family values, we've got the Arizona National Guard coming out. We've got pedal cars coming out for the kids, and we're having a hot dog race, a 5-second rush. We'll talk about that a little bit. K camel face painting, which is awesome. You have to paint these kids with
I do that every year.
Yeah, I know you do. But here's the cool part. They're going to give the kids a camel face pack. They get to take it home.
Oh, there are going to be more beds that night from the kids rolling around
yeah, let's
with
play.
It.
Yeah, we'll
Mom's got to do laundry.
Camel fluffy up.
Nice. Yep.
Yeah, get
all
up
right,
the bleach.
Hey, we're going to stand down. Thank Bill Luke Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram I-17 and West Camelback Road. Yep, since 1927. And some of our other sponsors. We'll be right back.
His mama stepped out of the crowd and started yelling out loud. Pray for
got the some big news. The bank finally came through, and I'm holding the keys to a brand new Chevrolet.
Chevrolet? No,
I didn't hear that.
Spell it R-A-M.
P-R-I-U-S.
Yeah. Hey, Kim, you don't know this, but Rocky Mountain Cummins has given us a bunch of throwouts.
Oh, cool. What
we have some Cummins diesel hats.
Ooh, that'll be worth
and
something.
And if you drive a Ford F-150, 250, or 350, you can have one. Nice. I'm just saying.
I can drive. I can wear one.
You have a Prius.
So? You see how big those batteries are?
Yeah.
You see my hamsters? Yeah. Come on.
Supercharged on Apple. I like it. A couple other things I want to mention. We talked a little bit about the cornhole thing, and you and Don really cleaned it up well. I wish Wally was here because he's like the resident cornhole master.
The master. He is a master.
Nice. From Nebraska, I might add. Go figure.
You have to visit YouTube and dial his name in for cornhole and his name and. You can watch him show you how it's done.
Serious?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
What's his name?
Wally Stokebrand.
I'll be darned.
Yeah.
Now, related to Luke, how?
He's the body shop manager.
That's the upper gene pool is Wally.
Thank you.
The whole dealership ticks around him. He'll tell you.
Yeah. And here's the deal. You can't goof it up bad enough, Wally can't fix it.
Serious.
Yep.
These guys are genius.
I've seen some stuff roll in that place, all kidding aside. I think the big one was a 2500 Ram that had hit something head on and then rolled.
Ooh.
And I mean, it was bent.
Every which way.
Yeah. And if it, you know, quite frankly, if you hadn't seen the Ram emblem, you'd have gone, what the hell was that? It took, I don't know, 45 days while I fixed it. Unbelievable. So that's a tribute to the Bill Luke Body Shop and the staff and the service department. We walked a guy from Dunkin' Donuts, Tim Nolan, through the dealership, and he goes, why am I going to a dealership, a car dealership? He was in awe. We went through the whole thing.
He's got the cornhole thing right there.
Yeah, there you go. All right, good stuff.
Edumacation process for JK. That
starts, registration for cornhole is Saturday. This is double team elimination, and cornhole play actually starts right at 10 o'clock. But we're up to, what, 100 teams, something like that?
Just probably going to just go over 100 teams, yeah.
Wow. Okay, does President Unmock of AZSFWC and O4E Eddie going to be playing?
You know, I sponsored them last year. What a waste of money. I didn't know they were going to start drinking after their first win.
This is not like bowling.
No,
it's not.
You don't get better.
The more beer you drink, you don't get any better. All right, so that's pretty cool. We talked a little bit about the military tank out there. The Arizona Military Vehicle Collectors Club will have an assortment of vintage military vehicles, and I understand we have a couple of motorcycles coming out. One's got a 50 caliber machine gun mounted. Your dad's ridden in that one.
Yes, he has.
Sam is bringing that out. We've got a Ural motorcycle, a Russian motorcycle with some things, hand grenades hanging on the handlebars. It's just wrong.
That is wrong.
Yeah, it is. And then I'm looking forward to... Let's talk a little bit about Billy Schumann.
Yes.
Race cars.
Yes, he will be out there. Billy Schumann will be out there with three of his antique, you might call them antique, but older champ cars or sprint cars.
Vintage.
Vintage. There you
Thank
go.
You.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And he was explaining to me, one of them, the one he drove way back when he first got started, it had the capability of putting a wing on it,
right,
or having the wing off of it. And the reason for that was, is in Arizona they ran with wings, and in California they didn't let them have, I'm sorry, not wings, cages. So he ran in California without a cage.
That's crazy.
And in Arizona he ran with a cage. And he was telling me all about that, California just thought it was a make them run faster and be more
We're talking sprint, open wheel dirt sprint cars.
Without a cage.
Without a cage.
That is crazy.
Just had one of those Indio roll bars on the back. That's all it would have
in
California.
Yeah, we know those didn't work very well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man. So he used to drive in those, but he was in my office for quite a while, and I watched him before I started racing. I was watching him at the early in my life, and then, of course, I raced when he raced. And him and his brother, Ronnie Schumann, were both just dynamite drivers.
Oh, they were.
Both went on to be in the World of Outlaws and a lot of places. So he's bringing out some of his vintage stuff and sprint cars and stuff, and he'll be there to talk to you the whole time. And so he has a museum of all of these kinds of race cars and stuff down at his museum, and I can't tell you exactly where it's at right now because I just got invited to go see it.
Cool.
And I haven't been there yet. So, but you can look it up, Vintage Race Cars Museum, and you can certainly go down there and take a look, and they tell me it's really neat to go there. You really see a lot
of
things.
We had some discussion about the old Hank Arnold Twister replica. Has that ever been located? I heard it was down in Tucson.
I don't know. I didn't ask him about
just
Hank
as
Arnold.
A point of curiosity.
I didn't ask him about Hank Arnold. He knew Hank real well, and so did I, actually.
Were you there the night
yes.
of the incident?
Yes.
Yeah.
I was. I was on the record that picked him up.
Oh.
So.
Moving right along. by the way, there is a Hank Arnold Memorial.
Right.
What we're talking about. So.
It was just a, it's just, it's the same incident as, happens in most cases. It was unusual. Shouldn't have happened, and got in the wrong situation and just wasn't in the right place.
Yeah, okay, let's get off that note and get on a more happy note. Kevin Turner's bringing out a new sprint car.
Mm-hmm.
They've got a young driver, you know, like we were talking, most of the guys coming up in the NASCAR world, 21, 22. I mean, these guys don't even shave yet. They're going, you know, 220 miles an hour.
They have something we don't. It's called reflexes.
No, they got a race car.
Yeah.
Kim and I would do that. There's no question. You give him a NASCAR.
Oh,
that's why he's got fenders on.
Yeah, we'd all do it. The only problem is we wouldn't do it well because we don't have the reflexes of a 22-year-old.
Yeah, you don't need reflexes. You just put people in the wrong position. You can go right by them.
Yeah, push on the gas and they fly right by. Yeah, dude.
Some of them even run into a wall.
We've got the Viper Clubs coming out. That's always a good show. Mopar Car Club's out there on Saturday. All makes models. Jeeps and rock crawlers. Looking forward to seeing that. And in the AMVCC, we have a ton of early Willys, World War II stuff.
That's cool.
Yeah, 42 to 46.
Yeah.
And boy, I mean, some really, really nice ones. All righty, when we come back, we're going to go to downtown Pace and see what the Mother Lake over at Roosevelt's happening and some of the stuff up on the rim with James Guggenhauer. Room Country Custom Rods. I'm Don McDowell.
I'm Kim Carter.
And?
Larry the Lizard.
JK.
Special K. Good man. Hey, can you give us an update on the Habitat Project?
Later.
Nice. All right.
Left my truck at the boat ramp and my boat is full of gas. My old boss thinks I'm sick today, he won't have me to harass. Cause I'm out here on the river and he can kiss my big old bass.
Alrighty, that means one thing. James Guggenhauer, our master rod builder in downtown Pace. And James, how's the weather up there, brother?
It's beautiful this morning. About low 40s. The breeze was blowing a little bit right at sunrise, but it's pretty calm now and a clear day.
That's a good thing. Well, hey, what's happening over on the Mother Lake?
Yeah, it's a perfect day to be on the water. You know, the big talk up here in Rim Country last week was the rainfall and the snow we had up on the rim. I heard one area got as much as 8 inches of snow up there.
Wow.
And like always, up here in the area, it snows one day, and in 2 days, it's all gone. So it's pretty well melted off, and the water's running down. Getting to the lake, just as an example, the Salt River, which was flowing last week at 250 cubic feet per second, is now flowing at 500 cubic feet per second. And the Tonto went from about 10 to about 1,500 cubic feet per second. Now, there's that big wave of water kind of made it down to the lake. And as I look at the reports this morning, they're starting to drop back down to normal or even below normal rates. But that big inflow of water stirred up a bunch of debris. I heard one report, I'll verify this week, but I heard the water is stained on the Tonto end all the way down to Rock Creek. So that gives people an idea of how much force the water brings down and how much it can stir up the water when it comes. Of course, that's good for fishing. You like to go up into that mud line right between where the water's clear and where it's stained is always a good place to fish. And
what color spinnerbait would you throw? I know what Kim would use, and it works. And I'll share that with you. You want me to share that or just keep that a secret?
You can share it.
You know, and a lot of people go with this in the spring, but a basically white skirt with chartreuse on it seems to work. You want to put your boat, here's the trick though, put your boat in the clear water, cast into the stained water, and retrieve back from the stained into the clear.
Go to the light.
Yeah, go to the light. You know, I'm going to let one of Kim's. Kim and I fish team for a couple times, and he shows up over at Roosevelt. He's got a chartreuse blade, chartreuse body, chartreuse skirt. And I looked at him like, what? I was trying to buy it from him after about 20 minutes. I mean, it was just absolutely whacking and stacking fish. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, moving right along.
So, anyway, reports are excellent on Roosevelt. You know, it's kind of funny. We're able to, just from the reports that we get from our local experts, we can watch all the pre-spawn activity going on. And a couple of weeks ago, we were talking about how the bass were all stacking up just outside of the spawning coves. This week, we're starting to hear reports on secondary points. So they're moving into those coves. They're moving back into the spawning grounds. So I'm guessing with the full moon coming next week on March 16th, the spawn is going to be well underway, and things are happening. There was a couple tournament on Roosevelt yesterday. 19 pounds was the winning weight.
Wow.
Ooh. Yeah.
What was big fish?
I didn't get that report. In fact, I just got a text of what the winning weight was. But everybody was amazed for Roosevelt because we haven't seen weights like that in a couple of years for a tournament.
Yeah, well, maybe the fishermen just did what they were supposed to be doing, let's just say. While we're talking, I'm looking at the All-Star results from Lake Pleasant yesterday. John and Janet sent those in. Their big fish was 434. Winning weight was
15 and
Vu. And Randy Cannata was, 1548, and that pretty much went on down to top 10. There was four and just under 13 pounds, four in the 13-pound range. And then second place, Carver and Whitaker were at 1456. So.
Yep. It's that time of year when those big fish come shallow. It's fun fishing time up there. But, you know, we're telling people that if you're fishing this week, you know, reaction kind of baits or what work this time of year. Bass are feeding before they go into the actual spawn activity. So crankbaits and soft plastic swim baits and those types of things are really working well right now.
Okay, are you coming down to Vasto's?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, man.
I'll be down there hanging right on your six. And
you better bring some comfortable walking shoes because we're going to be doing some walking.
Yeah, I understand. It's, you know, a lot of people looking forward to that. You know, every hour you're allowed to use live bait. Guys are talking about fish in a barrel, if you get my point.
I hear that. And on the live bait, Harry from Liar's Corner has 1,000 water dogs he's bringing out. And from what I understand, what was the word down at Wild Horse?
Wild Horse had probably a good 1,000 as well, but they were all sold.
Bam.
But he was supposed to be bringing in some more, so maybe that'll happen this week.
Just, you know, I'm still not tracking on this. Why do we have a shortage of water dogs, Kim?
Shortage of water.
We're going to start raising them as a part-time job.
Yeah, it's an Arizona Game and Fish thing, and you can take that up with Chief Cantrell.
I will.
There you go, Don.
Yeah.
Hey, you know that, Bill Loop Bass Days is getting close because on all the fishing websites, on the boards, the forums that guys post on, people are already asking for water dogs.
That's a good thing.
Oh, yeah.
Coming.
Yeah, there'll be some out there.
We look forward to seeing you down there and participating and all the guys. I know John Browning and a bunch of the guys are coming down, as always.
So, the Randall boys will be there.
Uh-oh.
So, look out. They'll be in the money, I'm sure. Ooh. They always try to figure out a way.
All right, that's good stuff. Hey, we'll see you next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, James. Looking forward to it.
Looking forward. Thanks, Don.
All right, James Guggenauer, check him out, Rim Country Custom Rods, and he will be in the house. We got a couple of minutes, Kim, before we got to flip into a break. One of the things that we're doing this year, we have Heroes on the Water coming out.
That's correct.
And they will be showing us what they do. They have kayaks for wounded warriors, and that can be physical, psychological, or otherwise, and they're going to be supported by Army Bass Anglers. You can check those guys out at armybassanglers.com. And I tell you, Major Cody got promoted to a colonel.
No.
Yeah. So I'm back at the Classic in Birmingham. And so I guess they do, you know, the Army's kind of a strange place. They give you promotion and then give you 5 months to get your retirement package.
You're ready to go.
You're out of here. He's got, I think, 23 years in. The U.S. Coast Guard Auxiliary will be there, and if you would like to have your boat inspected and Coast Guard certified, contact your boating insurance company. There may be a 10 to 15 to 20% discount for you. Kim, we've talked a lot of stuff.
I know. It just goes on and on.
Tell me again what's happening with the ride and drive.
Okay.
It's a little bit different this year than it was past.
Yeah, the ride and drive this year, first, well, we did last year too. We're giving a 50-inch TV away, anybody that takes a ride in a Dodge Ram.
Wow.
And there'll be people there to sign you up. And so when you get all done, we will draw that out after the tournament's all over with and then call you on the following Monday or Tuesday who has actually won.
Okay, so you don't have to be present to win.
No, you don't have to be present to win. And you take a ride in a Ram and you can drive it all around the area there. We have a little track that we produce and they can check it all out. And we'll have the 1500 there, the crew cab, the quad cab, the we'll have the 2500, the 3500, the 4500. I don't think we're going to have a 5500. Now, the 35 and the 4500, they will be dressed up for people that would be using them for plumbing, things of that sort. And they'll have racks and toolboxes on them. You can see how you can put the thing together so you can use it. There'll also be a flatbed out there as well, so you can see how that all works. And so you'll be able to go out there and see the whole Ram line.
The whole Ram family.
The whole Ram family.
Yeah, buddy. JK, you need to drive one.
There's no doubt about that. I need to rent one for a while.
Drive it like you stole it.
Oh, yeah.
All righty. Hey, we're going to stand down. Thank the rest of our sponsors. More with Larry the Lizard and Kim Carter and Special K.
You must look like someone I once knew.
All righty, we're back, getting this thing wrapped up. Man, glad to have Dwayne down here. Always a pleasure to see Dwayne.
He's a riot.
Yeah, but, you know, that guy is so talented. How long did he take music lessons?
Oh, I don't know that he ever took music lessons.
He took guitar lessons, which he failed at Heber High. Snowflake High
School. No, they taught them. They're self-taught.
Yeah.
All of them. With the banjo, the violin and the guitar.
I'll tell you what. Self-taught. Man, he can rip that violin.
Oh, I've watched him play Devil Went Down to Georgia a number of times.
Yeah, because he was scared to go to Alabama. Yeah. All righty, a couple more things. We're starting registration at 4 p.m. on Thursday afternoon. The tent registration area will be open 4 a.m. daily, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. What else are we missing, Chief?
Well, I kind of like to ask a question to Larry.
Yeah.
If I was going out to fish, and I bass days, okay, and I launched my boat, where would I go and what would I do?
If it was me?
Stay out of the marina.
Yeah, I'd like to get a hold of one of those big black tires, but other than that, I would... This is the honest to God's truth. I'm going to do exactly what I did last year. I'm going to go and I'm going to pre-fish. So if I was going to do this tournament seriously, I would pre-fish. And I'm going to do some pre-fishing. I would go up in the back of every creek channel. I would look at the bottom end of the lake as well, because the fish on the bottom to the top are going to be doing different things. I'm going to be looking for which bite is more active. Right now we know these fish are coming up to spawn. But a lot of the smaller fish are up in the spawning areas. The bigger fish are still out. So you may have to be using some baits to get down. And I know for one thing, I'm going to take that 10-inch Rattling Layer the Lizard, and I'm going to Carolina rig that thing in 20 feet of water, and I'm going to drag that thing around some shelves that are leading up into spawning bays, because that's where they should be stacked up. I mean, bass fishermen know, hey, they're coming up these channels into these spawning bays, and there's some pigs back in the back already, and there's more pigs coming in. So if you can find that channel that's coming back in, and the other thing I can tell you is, if you're not catching fish, you need to slow down. And like these Pro Tour rattling worms, I'm going to be drop-shotting these babies like crazy, because I've been killing them at Apache and at Roosevelt on these. I haven't got to use them a whole lot at Pleasant, but I did take some off of Pleasant. These you can get at Phoenix Fishing Supply and Liar's Corner right now. Sportsman's just called me this last week and said, hey, we're almost sold out of your lizards at the Phoenix and Tucson stores, so we need to get them stocked. But they're also looking at carrying these. I'm sorry?
Do you have them at Sportsman's Mesa?
Yeah, Sportsman's Mesa also carries them. But they have just been selling the daylights out of these. So that's really good. And you know, for this tournament, I'm really looking forward to it, because I'm planning on this being the third year in a row that I fished it, and the third year in a row that you're going to give me a paycheck again.
Hey, yeah, be welcome.
There's something incestuous about this relationship.
Everybody's
here.
Got their hand out.
Yeah.
That's right.
Anyway, let me ask you a question. As these pigs start coming through, or the hogs and all the rest of it, start to move from down below up to a spawning point and come around those ledges that you were talking about, are they actively feeding at that point?
Well, I'll tell you what, these fish come up in waves, and a lot of people don't realize how many waves of fish are coming in, because there can be who knows how many waves, but I'm talking not just one or two waves. I'm talking about 30, 40 different waves of fish coming in at different times. So you've got fish that are actively feeding in the deeper channels, that come up just to feed. You've got other fish that are setting up their beds. So you've got a huge transition.
Those fish become very territorial, not necessarily out of hunger, but out of defense and aggression.
Exactly. And I'll tell you what, I went out pre-fishing a week and a half ago for about half a day. I found some beds, and as soon as I saw the fish, I threw that little 6-inch lizard in just to see. And man, it was just crazy. Boom. I mean, and wow. I could hammer the same fish two or three times easily in a row. So I thought, wow, I can't believe these fish are actually that hard on beds this early, because the temperature was a little bit light for what I was thinking. It was only 59 degrees. So, and that was the peak temperature. And these are the same temperatures we're looking at all week. 80 degrees as the high, 55 at night. So we're looking at almost the same thing, but we've got cloudy yet sunny days. And I can't believe this forecast, because this lines up to be the biggest tournament in this state right now with the best fishing conditions, and the payouts are looking really good too. So I'm sitting here to myself licking my chops going, wow, I can't wait to get on the water, because this is going to be absolutely crazy. I'm going to drop shot that Pro Tour rattling worm, and then I'm going to take that big old lizard and find a bed, and it's just going to be crazy. And I'm going to be coming to see you. Definitely. You will be seeing me up there.
We'll be there with the money.
Hey, Kim, is that a man card violation? Find a big old lizard and get in bed? I'm just saying that.
Chew that.
Yeah, hoorah.
Hoorah.
Yeah, we got the Rulies out there. I mean, there's a lot of those guys camped out. Bill's got a new skeeter boat. Didn't want to fish in his 12-foot aluminum boat like he did last year. So he's got guys coming from California. Yeah, we got guys coming from all over the place, and it's an opportunity to pick up $10,000 for one fish. Second biggest bass gets a check for $3,000, and on and on and on. So
now listen to Larry, because he's got this bait, and I'm sitting here looking at it and playing with it, trying to tear it apart. And I'll tell you what, it's a elaborate bait. It's got a lot to it.
Bite it.
But you know what? The great thing is that last year, between Bill Luke and Sportsman's Warehouse, that little 6-inch lizard got me a $4,000 check, which is now why you're looking at this Pro Tour rattling worm that I've been using for 3 years and haven't been showing anybody.
Wow.
Okay, Kim, what else?
Well,
sign the book at the dealership.
Just remember,
book at Sportsman's.
Yeah, and bring all your kids out and bring all your family out, because everything on top, the rides, the fair type situations you'll see there with the car clubs and everything that's going on, and the tank and all the big trucks you can look at and wander through, and all your vendors and things that are happening, and it just goes on and on and on. Bring your family. They will enjoy themselves completely, and there's no cost.
There's one last thing that I want to emphasize. Please go down to Sportsman's Warehouse and sign the registry, and Bill Luke to sign the registry, because if I hadn't done that last year, I would have missed out on thousands of dollars.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there's $3,000 worth of bonus money.
There's plenty of people signing it, so if you
don't JK,
yeah,
we're glad to see you out there. Are you going to be dancing and playing in the band? Wish I had a boat.
I want that Cabana Boy girl.
yeah. Wish I had a truck.
See?
You can put your Prius on display.
Thank you. No, thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, that's all good. All right, that's it, guys. It's starting registration again Thursday afternoon. It's still time to we're going to be pulling.
It's time to happen.
We're going
to
be pulling the book at the dealership Thursday afternoon.
That's correct.
Okay, we've already.
When Donna leaves our store, which is our comptroller, she will be taking the book with her, and it'll be around noon.
Yes. And one word of advice is do not antagonize Donna.
Don't antagonize Donna.
Boy, I made a mistake of beating on the door last year. I'm not ever going to do that again. Who knows?
Who's there?
Yeah, she's like, wait, is she 5 foot three?
Yeah, she carries a gun, too.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Now you tell them.
Oh, good. Those no weapon signs are going to come out handy for her. All righty, guys. Hey, we will see you at Bill Luke Fast Days, downtown Pleasant Harbor RV Resort and Marina. On Thursday, I'm Don McDowell with
Special K,
Larry the Lizard,
Kim Carter.
God love you, Kim. Thanks for coming down, and I've heard it time and time again. Thank you. Thank Don Luke for making this thing happen for the fishermen and the families. I'm Don McDowell. We're going to go hug the bass boat, take the kids fishing, and we'll see you at the lake Thursday. We're out of here.